and welcome. This is Nasreen Sheikh and you're watching It's Tomorrow News. Tropical storm Quiel may intensify into typhoon. Cyclone Bulbul to become severe cyclonic storm. Deadly 5.9 magnitude earthquake hits northwestern Iran. Severe tropical storm Quiel has maintained its strength while remaining almost stationary on Thursday night, the State Weather Bureau said. In its 11 p.m. weather bulletin, Quiel was spotted 375 km west-northwest of Coron, Palawan, while packing maximum sustained winds of 110 km per hour with 135 km per hour gust. The weather disturbance may intensify into a typhoon within 24 hours. Pagasa said, however, Quiel may leave the Philippines area of responsibility on Friday night at the earliest. Meanwhile, a super typhoon tracking northwest over the Pacific remains outside the Philippines area of responsibility. Typhoon Halong was last spotted 3,075 kilometers east-northeast of extreme northern Luzon while packing maximum sustained winds of 150 kilometers per hour with 185 kilometers per hour gust while moving north at 10 kilometers per hour. Between Thursday evening and Friday evening, light to moderate with occasional heavy rains will be experienced over Cagayan, including Babuyan Island and Apayao. Light to moderate with intermittent heavy rains will affect Kalinga, Ilocos, Norte, Palawan, Mindoro provinces. Akalan and Antique Quiel remains unlikely to make landfall in the country and there are no areas under tropical cyclone wind signals. But rain caused by the severe tropical storm will persist in some areas in Luzon and the Visayas on Friday, November 8. The National Disaster Risk Reduction and Management Council said in a separate statement on Thursday that the Mines and Geoscience Bureau assessed 1,015 barangays with high to very high susceptibility to rain-induced flooding and at least 620 also with high and very high susceptibility to rain-induced landslides. As predicted, the deep depression in Bay of Bengal finally intensified into a cyclonic storm Bulbul on Thursday morning. This is the seventh cyclonic of the season, while first for the Bay of Bengal during the post-monsoon season. The system is presently marked over east-central Bay of Bengal and centered about 680 km south-southeast of Paradeep, Odisha, 775 km south-southeast of Sagar Island. West Bengal and 800 km south-southeast, Cyclone Bulbul would continue to track north-northwestwards in favorable weather conditions and further strengthening into a severe cyclonic storm in the next 24 hours. In fact, chances are bright for the system to even intensify into a very severe cyclonic storm. It is expected to make landfall around November 10 between Chandbali and Sagar Island. According to weathermen, Bulbul would continue to move in the sea for the next 3 days before recurving. It would then move along the east coast, possibly skirts the North Odisha, West Bengal coast. However, climatologists suggest that tropical storm forming in Bay of Bengal during this time of the year usually head towards east, for example, Bangladesh or Myanmar. Meanwhile, sea conditions would remain rough to very rough all along the east coast. Complete suspension of fishermen activities are advised along and off Odisha and West Bengal coast from November 8 to 10. Meanwhile, at least 4 people were reported killed and 20 other injured when a shallow 5.9 magnitude earthquake struck northwestern Iran early on Friday, according to state TV. The United States Geological Survey said the quake struck around 60 kilometers from the town of Hestad in East Azerbaijan province shortly before 2:30 a.m. local time on Friday. Press TV confirmed that 4 people were killed and 70 were injured. The USGC issued an alert warning that significant casualties are likely and the disaster is potentially widespread. Images and videos posted online showed a collapsed structure in Miane, also in East Azerbaijan province, near the epicenter of the quake. Residents were also seen camping outside their homes or in their cars. There have been several aftershocks reported since the earthquake struck. Iran sits where two large tectonic plates meet and sees frequent seismic activity. The country has suffered a number of major disasters in recent decades, including at the ancient city of Bam, which was decimated by a catastrophic earthquake in 2003 that killed at least 31,000 people. In 1990, a 7.4 magnitude quake in northern Iran killed 40,000 people, injured 300,000, and left half a million homeless, reducing dozens of towns and nearly 2,000 villages to rubble. Iran has experienced at least three other significant quakes in recent years, one in 2005 that killed more than 600 people and another in 2012 that left some 300 dead. In 2017, at least 600 people were killed when a 7.3 earthquake hit Iran's Kermanshah province. That's all for now. For more news updates, stay tuned with us. It's Tomorrow News, Nasreen Sheikh. For more weather updates, do like, share and subscribe our channel.